Today we're going to cover a formula I had never seen before. Now, it's technically not a formula. It's special syntax in a formula that I'd never seen. If you've seen the syntax before, or you're using it in your Excel formulas in your files, please let me know in the comments, because I'd be really interested to see how you're using it. So let me give you some context. What we want to do is to count the text values in here, so in our output column. And we want to exclude numbers and formulas that result in blank cells or empty strings. If you take a look at the output column, it looks like we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 texts in there and one number. Our formula should just give us the number of text cells in there. So it should exclude this number, but here's the thing, it should exclude these blank cells, and it should also exclude formula results that end up giving us empty strings. So in this case, this is not technically a blank cell, it's an empty string. If I type is blank and I highlight this and close the bracket, press enter, bland no is blank, it tells me it's false because it's not blank. And if I reference it to this cell and press enter, it's true. It's technically, in Excel's eyes, it's not blank. Now, what I want to do is to ignore this in my count. Here's a formula that one of our community members, Jack, sent me. And he said he needed to do this in his work situation. And he had come across this formula, and it works, but he doesn't understand why it works. And if I know why it works. But I didn't. I also asked Bob Umbles if he's seen this syntax before in Excel formulas, and he said he hasn't come across this. So let me show you what that is. We're gonna start with COUNTIF, right? Because we wanna count if this range meets our criteria. So COUNTIF we've all seen, right? So I'm gonna highlight this range. But now for criteria, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna use does not equal, right? So that's the sign for doesn't equal, but we're gonna do it the other way around, like angry eyes instead. So we're gonna do this one and then put it in quotation mark. So basically we're just gonna type it wrong and we're gonna press enter, and that gives us 5, right? So it works, it's only counting text. Now, if you have other numbers other than 0, they're also not included. All of these empty strings are not included. Why does it work? If you know why it works, please comment below. A logical way of writing this would be to use the COUNTIF function, and instead of giving that weird sign, we could give it wildcards. We have some wildcard characters in Excel, like we have the question mark and the asterisk sign. The asterisk sign, this one, is a placeholder for text that's any length. It can be 1 character, 2, 3, or more. And the question mark is the placeholder for just one character. If we want the cell result to at least be one character and it should be text, we can use this combination. We can put the question mark, the asterisk sign, and then put in the quotation mark, close bracket, press enter, and we get 5. This I understand. This one I don't understand. Actually, what happens if we type it the other way, if we say doesn't equal to? What type of count do we get then? What do you think we're gonna get if I do this? Okay, so we're just saying it doesn't equal to and press enter. I get 8. So basically it's including every cell except the truly blank cells, right? So it's including this one, but it doesn't include this one, right? Because that's a truly blank. That's actually one thing you can use if you wanted to get this result back. You might ask, what formula could I use if I wanted to count text or number, but I don't want to count these blank ones and I don't want to count cells that have formulas that result in empty strings? Well, I'm not sure if with COUNTIF you can do that, but the first formula that comes to my mind is to use the sum product formula. And all I have to do is just to check if the length of the text in these cells is at least one character. So it can be a number, it can be text, it doesn't matter. But we're just gonna take a look at the length. So I'm gonna use the len formula and check is this bigger than zero? So let me just make sure my brackets are clear. I need to close two brackets. This is gonna give me a bunch of true and false values. So if I highlight this and I press F9, say I get true, false. And to be able to turn these into ones and zeros, I have to do some type of mathematical operation on this. So I could multiply this with one, or I'm gonna put two minus signs there. That's gonna do the job. And press enter, I get 6. With this formula, I get to add up cells that have text as well as numbers. So if there happens to be a 3 here, notice that this one updates my sum product, it includes that. This one didn't update. If this changes to just put a T in there, this one updates, and well, this one updates as well because it's at least one character. These are different formulas you can use to count cells with text or with numbers and exclude blank cells, and also exclude cells that result in an empty string. And don't forget, if you know what this does, comment below and let us know. Thank you to Jack for bringing this to my attention. It's just really interesting to find these little hacks in Excel. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you like what you see, if you haven't subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing before you leave. And I'm gonna see you in next week's video.